Hi guys, welcome back to Sublime 77. I'm Regina Stoneham, and today we're going to address 10 Lyme disease basics. The number one rule you should know is that Lyme disease initially is spread by the bite of a tick. Yes, a tick bite. And the tick has to be on your skin for at least 24 hours for Lyme disease to be transferred to you. Fewer than 50% of Lyme disease patients recall even being bit by a tick. In my case, I don't remember being bit by a tick. I don't know how long I've had Lyme disease. I've had it for over 20 years. Fewer than 50% of people with Lyme disease recall any kind of a rash. Now, usually doctors say that there's going to be a bullseye rash if you are bitten by a tick, but fewer than 50% remember a bullseye rash, and I am one of them. I do not recall any bullseye rash. There are 5 subspecies of Borrelia burgdorferi. There are over 100 species in America, and over 300 worldwide. Can you believe this, people?
Borrelia burgdorferi. That's the Lyme disease.
The Borrelia burgdorferi are spirochetes, and so they look like little spirals, and they can spiral anywhere they want. They can spiral into your heart, they can spiral into your brain, they can go anywhere.
And they can hide, and they can multiply.
Okay, so the longer you have Lyme disease, the harder it is to get rid of it because there's so much in your body. That's my rant on Borrelia burgdorferi. Testing for co-infections such as Ehrlichia, Anaplasma, Bartonella, Babesia, they should be tested for also, not just Lyme disease. So when the tick bites you and leaves this wonderful Lyme disease, it just doesn't leave the Lyme disease. It can leave the other co-infections as well as viruses such as Epstein-Barr. Yes. This little tiny tick can leave all of those horrible things in your body. And the longer you have it in there, the worse it gets. Any spirochetal infection that's ongoing and not treated causes chronic Lyme disease. Chronic Lyme disease. So that's in my case. I was not treated for Lyme disease. I was not tested for Lyme disease, and I've had it for over 20 years, and so now I have chronic Lyme disease. There has been no test demonstrating that 30 days of antibiotics can cure chronic Lyme disease. Most doctors believe that if you have Lyme disease, whether it be right at the beginning or you've had it for a really long time, they usually just treat you for 30 days of antibiotics.
That's pretty scary.
Most cases of chronic Lyme disease require an extended period of time of treatment in order to become symptom free. That means more than 1 month, more than 2 months, more than 3, it could be up to 2 years. Lyme disease is considered the great imitator, such as arthritis, neurological disorders, fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, and many more. So if you have many, many symptoms and you have no answers, please get tested for Lyme disease. Rule that out first before you get a diagnosis of symptoms. If you suspect that you have a tick-borne illness, please go see a healthcare practitioner that knows about Lyme disease, that knows how to treat it, and knows about the symptoms. There's a lot of doctors out there that do not know, and you have to do your research. always do your research in finding a doctor that will meet your needs. You can watch the video called Under Our Skin. It's on the iLads website. It's also on Amazon, and it's a great, great documentary about Lyme disease. It will give you a better awareness and understanding of this disease. If you would like more information, please go to ilads.org. Also, subscribe and get more educational and inspirational videos.